إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls the believers, in a way blaming them for thinking or deciding something. Here is the call: Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O ye who believe, ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله. What is wrong with you? Why every time that you are called to march in the cause of Allah, to do something in the cause of Allah, إذا قلتم إلى الأرض, you clinging to earth, you don't want to move, you don't want to respond. Here it is: أَرَضِيتُمْ بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ. Have you decided that dunya is what you want instead of the hereafter? Is that what you decided? You decided that الدنيا is what you want, الآخرة, the hereafter, Jannah, is not in your calculations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you, فَمَا مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Indeed, the enjoyment of this dunya in comparison to the whole hereafter, it's just a little. Allah يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ وَفَرِحُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows His provision upon whomever He wants, and they are so happy with the dunya. And indeed, the dunya in comparison to the hereafter is a little bit, is nothing. Nothing, brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. The hereafter is far greater for you, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, than this dunya. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the hadith fi sahih Muslim, hadith al-Mustawrid ibn Fihr radiyallahu anhu, he said this: إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ. The likeness of the dunya in comparison to the hereafter is like someone who dips his finger in the ocean. And actually, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did like this to them. He showed it to them like this. And he pulled his finger again. And then he asked, look what you get out of that ocean with that finger. في سنن ابن ماجه حديث عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was sleeping in a mat, a hard place to sleep on, so it printed on his body. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu comes rushing bi abi anta wa ummi ya Rasulullah, we should have given you something that protect your back, your body from that mat. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, mali wa dunya, I don't want anything from the dunya. Innama ana wa dunya, the likeness of me and the dunya is like somebody who's traveling and he found the shade of a tree, then he sought some shade for a while and then he went on traveling. The dunya is the shade. There are hadith and words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that curses the dunya, this world. Ad-dunya mal'una. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used this word with ad-dunya. Ad-dunya is cursed. The hadith fi sunan al-Tirmidhi, hadith Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu. One day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was walking with his companions. Fara'a jidyan asak. He saw a goat, a male goat, whatever it is, has no ears, dead. He pointed out and he said, this dunya in the sight of Allah is like that male goat. I can stand here and cite you Quran and Sunnah that proves to you, brothers and sisters in Islam, that this dunya is madhmuma, blameworthy. The only place where the dunya is praiseworthy is once it is used as a farm where you plant something that you expect the harvest in the hereafter. Let me repeat this again. The dunya, the whole world, is blameworthy, is cursed. The only time this world, this life that you're living, is praiseworthy, if you use it to earn the hereafter. That's it. Now, a question that I ask you and I ask myself: are we treating the dunya this way, or are we going too far with it? Brothers and sisters in Islam, the reality is the majority of Muslims, they do not know what is in store for them with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah. And that is why Their decision is in a way focused on the dunya. Yes, they hear about Jannah. They hear about it. It's nice. It's a good place. But they do not understand that the Quran and the Sunnah has tremendous amount of details that explains to you all about Jannah and what you are missing. In the minutes to come, I just want to share with you some of what is in store in Jannah for you. And at the end, you're going to have to make a decision still. Should your focus continue or continues to be around this dunya, or should you change? Brothers and sisters in Islam, I found no better description to Jannah than the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of Jannah, mentioned in the Quran and in his hadith Qudsi, sacred speech. Here is one. And the hadith fi sahih Muslim, hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, listen to this, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Wallahi, if there is nothing else beside that word عبادي would have been sufficient. I prepared for my righteous. Allah is telling you, I prepared for my righteous servants. Enough that you come under this. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala included you. أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحِينَ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ. What an eye never seen. وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ. What an ear never heard. وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. And whatever you think of, whatever wish you have in Jannah, done. Immediately. All you have to say, سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمْ دَعْوَاهُمْ فِيهَا سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمْ. Done. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about someone in Jannah who will have a wish to be a farmer. That's what he wanted to do. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him that wish. Now you can imagine. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there are some announcements that will be made in Jannah. Announcements to the people of Jannah, to the dwellers of Jannah. Let's share with you just five of them. The first four in one hadith, fi sahih Muslim, again, hadith Abi Huraira, radiyallahu anhu. إذا دخل أهل الجنة الجنة. When the people of Jannah enter Jannah, ينادي مناد, a caller will call. يا أهل الجنة. O dwellers of Jannah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all dwellers of Jannah. Inna lakum an tahyaw fala tamutu. Wa inna lakum an tasihhu fala tasqamu. Wa inna lakum an tashubbu fala tahramu. Wa inna lakum an tan'amu fala tab'asu. Four. Inna lakum أن تحيوا فلا تموتوا. You are promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are to live and never die. This this by itself is a killer, as they say. Look at you here in this dunya. Wallah, regardless of what you have, you're threatened. You're living with fear day in and day out. You're afraid you're going to be taken away from it. You will die, akhi. You will die, sister. In Jannah, no more death. لا يذوقون فيها الموت إلا الموتة الأولى. They will not taste death except the first death that they tasted in the dunya. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will actually materialize death for you in a form, transform death into a form of a horned ram, and will be placed between Jannah and hellfire. And both dwellers of Jannah and dwellers of the hellfire will be asked, do you know who this is? They will say yes. And then that horned ram will be slayed, will be slaughtered. And then it will be said to the dwellers of Jannah, eternity. And to the dwellers of the hellfire, eternity. The hadith fi Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu. No more death. No more death in Jannah. You will live for eternity, forever. You and Jannah will last forever. Two, وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَصِحُّوا فَلَا تَسْقَمُوا. And you will be so healthy and you will never be sick. No diseases, no insurance, nothing of that. Nothing. No sickness in Jannah. People will be refashioned. They will take the shape of their father Adam. 60 dhira, 60 arm length, 60 dhira. They will not even need to go to the bathroom. A'azzakumullah. They will not spit. They will not blow their nose. Different life. You will be refashioned in a way that you will eat and drink not out of need to eat and drink. Actually, you eat and drink for pleasures, just for the enjoyment of eating and drinking. And you don't have to worry about becoming fat. Something different, brothers and sisters in Islam. Something different in Jannah. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَصِحُّوا فَلَا تَسْقَمُوا. Three, وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَشُبُّوا فَلَا تَهْرَمُوا. And you will always stay youth. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi sunan al-Tirmidhi, hadith Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, he said that the people of Jannah will be around the age of 30 and 33. And you don't grow old. Regardless of how much you reach in this dunya, you will be brought back to 30 and 33. And you will not grow old. The fourth announcement, Ya Ahl al-Jannah, O people of Jannah, Wa inna lakum an tan'amu, fala tab'asu. And you are to be in pleasure continuously. Enjoyment, continuous enjoyment. No more miserliness. No more misery. No more misery or even fear of misery. Even Jannah, brothers and sisters in Islam, is a place where you forget your misery in this dunya. Look what kind of hardship that you're going through in this dunya. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you that one dip in Jannah, hadith Anas ibn Malik fi Sahih Muslim radiyallahu an Anas, one dip in Jannah One dip, and you will be taken out and asked. And you will be asked, did you see misery before this? Did you experience any hardship before this? The person will swear by Allah, La wallah ya Rabb, forgotten. Jannah, brothers and sisters in Islam. There is a mall in Jannah. Every Friday you get to go shopping. Inna fil jannati lasuqa. Marketplace. Not like this dunya. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you pick up a fruit, another one grows in its place. أكلها دائم وظلها. You don't have to climb. وذللت قطوفها تذليلا. It will be brought down to you. You go to restaurants in this dunya, they make these waitresses and waitress serve you, and they will give you a smile, and most probably a plastic one for tips. Who serves you in Jannah? وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وُلْدَانٌ مُخَلَّدُونَ. Angels, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fashioned just to serve you. You will be reclining in sofas, chatting and talking to your friends. And you will actually call some of the events in this dunya. You will remember some of the things that you had in this dunya. Inna kunna qablu fi ahlina mushfiqin. Drinks. I call upon those Muslims who are amongst us today and they drink alcohol. If you continue, you will be deprived from a drink, from a wine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for you in Jannah. Even if you enter Jannah, by the way, a Muslim who dies without repenting from drinking alcohol, even if he gets to go to Jannah later on, he will be deprived from the wine. لَذَّة لِلشَّارِبِينَ. Look at you as you drink that stinky drink in this dunya. You swallow it because you just want to get high. In Jannah, لَذَّة. Taste good. And you're not going to throw up. You're not going to look like a weirdo in Jannah. Different. Why are you replacing this for this? Come on. What kind of a decision are you making? Brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the best enjoyment in Jannah, the greatest prize ever, you know what? Looking at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wujuhun yawma'idhin nadira ila rabbiha nadira. On that day, faces will be beaming in happiness, joy, because they are looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَةِ. Those who fought themselves, stopped themselves from doing the haram, and they that did a lot of ihsan, they will receive the husna, jannah, waziyada, and more. More is looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. They will have whatever they want in Jannah, and they will have more. More is looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes for us this moment in hadith Suhayb al-Rumi radiyallahu anhu fi Sunan ibn Majah wa al-Tirmidhi bi sanadin sahih. Yunada ala ahli al-Jannah. The dwellers of Jannah, they will be called upon. The caller will say, and this is the fifth announcement, Ya Ahlal Jannah, O dwellers of Jannah, إن لكم عند الله موعدا يريد أن ينجزكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised you something that He wants to fulfill His promise. The dwellers of Jannah will say, فيقولون وما هو. They are enjoying Jannah already. They are in Jannah. What that could be? ألم يبيض وجوهنا ويثقل موازيننا ويدخلنا الجنة وينجينا من النار وينجينا من النار. Hasn't He brightened our faces, made our scales so heavy? Hasn't He admitted us into Jannah? Hasn't He subhanahu wa ta'ala saved us from the hellfire? What else could that be? فيكشف الحجاب, and the veil will be removed. فينظرون إلى ربهم, and they will look at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم swears, فوالله فوالله ما أعطوا شيئا أحب إليهم ولا أقر لأعينهم من النظر إلى وجه ربهم. By Allah, nothing that they were given previously in Jannah is dearer to them and more satisfactory to them than looking at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who look at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is Jannah and more. But now the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you في حديث في الحاكم حسن ألا إن سلعة الله غالية, حديث أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه, ألا إن سلعة الله غالية. الله سبحانه الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم tells you, indeed the commodity of Allah is expensive. Look at all these pleasures, they are not, it's not cheap. It is not cheap. It is expensive. أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْجَنَّةِ. The community of Allah is Jannah. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to prompt the companions to do something, he would remind them of Jannah. Who can prepare the army and he will get Jannah? Who can go and get me this and he will have Jannah? Who can do this and he will be my companion in Jannah? Always. That first generation of Muslims were living in earth and their hearts are so attached to Jannah. To the extent that some of them, they used to say, I smell the odor of Jannah behind the mountain of Uhud. Anas ibn al-Nadr رضي الله عنه. Another one holding some dates in his hand. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was revealed to him that this person will die as a shaheed in one of the battles. He throws the dates. I'm not going to wait until Jannah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is an expensive commodity, and it requires a lot of sacrifice. في سنن الترمذي وسنن أبي داود من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, لما خلق الله الجنة, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى created الجنة, He called Abun Jibril عليه السلام, and he told him, Ya Jibril, O Jibril, go and look at it. Jibril alayhi salam went and looked at the Jannah, and he came back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he said, Ay Rabb wa izzatika la yasma'u biha ahadun illa dakhalaha. By your glory, by your honor, O Allah, my Lord, no one will hear of it unless we'll enter it, because of the amount of pleasures that are inside the Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surrounded the Jannah with the difficulties and the dislikes. You have to pray 5 times. You cannot drink alcohol. You cannot go around have relationship with women without marriage. You have to give, spend in the cause of Allah. Dislikes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surrounded Jannah with dislikes. Things that you will have to force yourself to do. Because your nafs, your souls will dislike to do it. Your nafs likes to do the easy stuff. And then he told Jibreel alayhi salam, go back and look at it. Jibreel went and he looked at the Jannah. Again being surrounded with all these difficulties. And he came back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he said, Ayy Rabb, my Lord, wa izzatika, I'm afraid no one will be able to enter it. It takes a lot of guts. And that is why, by the way, you're not going to have a real state in Jannah. A real state problem. Because the majority of the people, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ وَإِنْ تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّوكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. You need to understand this, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Jannah and Hellfire, which are already, both are created, He created places for all mankind in both. In both. All mankind have places in Jannah. Now the majority of mankind will go to the Hellfire. Now guess who will inherit these places in Jannah? وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا. This is beside your Jannah, there is another Jannah that you will inherit. بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. So, you're not going to have a real state in Jannah. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about the last person who will come out of the hellfire and enter Jannah. Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu fil Bukhari wa Muslim. You know how much his property will be? How much he will own? 10 times this dunya. Not Lanham. Not New York. Not Washington. No, the dunya. 10 times. And that is why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you, لَمَوْضِعُ صَوْطٍ فِي الْجَنَّةِ خَيْرٌ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا وَلَغَدْوَةٌ أَوْ رَوْحَةٌ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. Hadith Sahl ibn Sa'd al-Sa'di fi Sahih al-Bukhari, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you that a distance that is occupied by a whip in Jannah is better than this dunya and what's in the dunya. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. O ye who believe, what is wrong with you? Ma lakum idha qila lakum. What is wrong with you? Whenever you're asked to march for Allah, to do something for Allah, you're clinging to earth. Did you decide to go for the dunya instead of the hereafter? Bad deal. Very bad.